Beautiful, beautiful day, but I have to introduce myself because we're online right now, so I want to say hi to folks. We are online, okay. This is Jim McLaughlin, live from Central Trinity United Methodist Church in Zanesville, Ohio, and I know Gary is probably watching from California, and my brother probably from Cincinnati, so there's several others who are watching that way, but happy to have you here in person as well as those online. This is my 24th recital. I was only going to do one of those after we rebuilt the organ, but it seemed like fun, so we kept doing it. But it should have been my 25th, but because of last year's pandemic, it's not there. So happy you're with us, and have some major Bach for you today. I don't know what you did during the pandemic. You know, you probably cleaned out the attic and the garage and a few things and did some projects you were going to do someday. Well, I got all those done, and I thought, well, maybe I should learn a song I was always going to learn someday, and so that's what I did for you today. The first Bach number, the St. Anne Prelude by Johann Sebastian Bach, number 552, was the first piece of music that he prepared to be published. Before Bach's time, people just sort of wrote music for themselves or for their own church or their own orchestra, but Bach started later in his life. He was 54 at the time that he wrote this in 1739, that he wrote really was a German organ mass that started with the prelude and ended with the fugue, and in between he had all the different portions of the mass, pieces of music written for that also. So today I'm starting the recital with the prelude and I'll end it with the fugue, so they have the exact same numbers because they're intended to be a part of this German organ mass. The number three in religion is very important, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. And the number three is going to appear a zillion times in this piece of music. First of all, it's an E flat, so it has three flats. Second of all, it has three sections. And then he chose three different styles. The first section is in the French overture style. The second section is in the Italian concerto style. And the third section is a German double fugue. So we having two fugues going on at the same time. We'll see if you can catch that. But anyway, this is the point in time that Bach was at St. Thomas Church in Leipzig. And us on this side of his life know that he's one of the 10 top composers that ever was born. But at Bach's time, he was actually the second choice for the organ job at St. Thomas Church in Leipzig. Telemann was the first one that was offered it, and Telemann turned him down. And that job was hired by the city council. So I'm, you know, in Zanesville, I don't know if we'd want to go to the city council and ask who you'd want to hire for an organist for Central Trinity Church. But at that point, it was run by the city council. And so Bach was the second choice, the better choice. So this was good also. So anyway, sit back, fasten your seatbelts, and enjoy, hopefully, my pandemic Bach for you, his prelude in E-flat major. And Lucas is my able page turner, because I can't get through there without a page turner.
Thank you.
neglected to mention one thing. That's the longest prelude that Bach ever wrote also, 10.5 minutes. So you get a gold star, and you'll be welcome to get cookies today for sitting through that, because we have cookies today. Well, to sort of be a dessert for you right now, Marge is coming up. We usually like to do an organ piano duet at these recitals. All these people volunteer to help me, by the way, you'll see as you come along. But Marge and I are stretching ourselves because we thought that What a Friend We Have in Jesus would certainly be a comforting song to have after that. But what if it was done in a jazz style? So there's Joe Utterbeck, writes some wonderful things for pipe organ and piano. So sit back and watch us sweat up here a little bit, because we are not jazz artists, but we're going to try our best to be jazz artists. Well, I hope you noticed we were having a ball, but that was not in our regular style of music play, so stretch this a little bit. Next, I want to feature one of my organ students, Lucas Reitz. He's ready to start playing services here at the church, I think. He's coming along beautifully, plays trombone beautifully, plays the piano beautifully, and just a fine young man, and he had homecoming yesterday, and football game Friday in Morgan County or something, got home late. And so I'm just so proud of him still being with me Sunday and turning my pages. Anyway, one of my responsibilities, I think, as a music educator, is to be preparing the next person that's going to take over in church positions, that we need church musicians, just like we need pastors and we need leaders in the church. And so I'm so pleased that Lucas is coming along and seems to enjoy what he's doing here. So the first number he's going to do is a collection of three hymns, and you'll probably know at least two of them, maybe all three of them. And then he's going to do a little Bach. You know, it's good to have a little Bach also. So sit back and enjoy, Lucas.
Thank you.
Next, I'm going to move over to the piano and play a couple pieces, and I would like for you to let me to put both of these pieces together as a set. So I love applause, but let's not applaud after the first one. Let me do this second before you applaud. One of the real blessings as a church musician is being with people at the saddest time of their life and the happiest time of their life. And this Consolation, I played for a cousin's funeral in August. There were two McLaughlins in Highland County that died last December, one on December 23rd and the other on December 24th. And they waited to have the memorial service until they thought it was a safer time. And one of the real pleasant things that came out of this is I got to know this cousin's children, because I really didn't know, I knew the cousin, but I didn't know their children. And their children both play the piano. And so they had a whole list of things that Jim was supposed to play. And one was this Consolation by Liszt. And I have not played anything by Liszt since I was a junior in high school, and I played Liebestraum with the school choir. And they sang Dream of Love, and I played Liebestraum on the piano. And I sweat so much on that, I thought I'll never do another Liszt piece. Well, here's another Liszt piece. And come to find out that Franz Liszt really wrote this piece, they think, in honor of Frederic Chopin, who had just died the year before. Because Chopin wrote so many beautiful nocturnes. So this first piece, I played for an aunt or a cousin's funeral in August, and I'll share that with you. And there, I'm certain there's people that you've lost in this last year or two that are very close to you. I know my good friend Leroy Kranz from Grace Church. I miss him every day. And right here in Central Trinity, Paul Thompson, one of our major musicians in the church choir. And we played in a memorial band the whole summer long in the parks. And he is now gone to his maker also. The other side of the thing is I played a lot of weddings this summer. And in fact, Renee and I did a wedding last Saturday that was for the daughter of a former piano student of mine. And I couldn't turn down a former piano student to play for her weddings. But this one was the rolling wedding that was over at Muskegon University. And what I'm gonna play for you, wedding day at Troldhaugen, was what she came down the aisle on. And I never thought about that, but it fits the title well, and I had to practice. So you're gonna get to hear that also, some happy music also. Well, very happy music, and that big court, bride was there. It was time for the ceremony to begin. The next number I played for another wedding here, and Sims's wedding, and I want you to see how much I sweat through this, Anne, because there's 42 page turns, and I didn't have a Lucas back then, so I had to do it myself. So this was at her wedding. This is Arrival of the Queen of Sheba. That was one of the requests, and we always try to make the bride happy. Thank you. I didn't complain, Ann, but that was a lot of, I had to really do a lot of thinking how I could get through this with 9 pages or 10 pages or whatever. The next two hymns are in your hymn book if you want to follow along. I'm going to do the second one first, Sing Praise to God Who Reigns Above. That's page 126. And then I'll go back to the God of Abraham Praise, and that's 116. So you can go back from 126 to 116 to follow along. I thought the God of Abraham Praise, after I made the program, made a better closing, so I turned it around. We have several connections to Richard Elliott, the arranger of this. One is, he's the principal organist for the Mormon Tabernacle Choir. So you've all seen Mormon Tabernacle Choir on television, especially at Christmas, when they have specials all the time. And but then there's a Louis Patterson connection also, who is a Zanesville boy, that he's the vice president of Schoenstein Organ Company in San Francisco. And they built the organ for the Mormons' big assembly hall that seats 27,000 in Salt Lake City. And they also tend the alien Skinner that's in the tabernacle. Now this is an E.M. Skinner organ from 1924. It's getting close to its 100th birthday. Well, after the Skinner Company started to have financial problems, they connected with another organ company called the Aeolian Company, and they formed the Aeolian Skinner Organ Company, and they built the organ for the tabernacle for Salt Lake City. So this organ has a connection in spirit also. But anyway, I think you'll enjoy. I get to play the melody with the right hand, I get to play with the melody with the pedals, I get to play the melody with the left hand. So you can sort of follow me working around the keyboard. But I'm first going to start with Sing Praise to God. Let's do this as a set again. You'll wait until I get really noisy on the first song for your applause. I love applause, but not at this moment. play at the Lost Chord before on recital, but I wanted to bring it back to you again this year. And I need to say the people online, the microphones that are in the pipe chamber are behind the shades, so you won't get to hear the dynamic contrast that the live audience gets to hear here, but you'll get to hear the organ at full blast all the way through. This Lost Chord in the musicians building, thinking of organists, the little quiet organist would come up and sit on the organ and then blow the windows out of the church, you know, a little quiet, shy person. And the poem came before the tune. The poem was written by Adelaide Proctor in 1858 in the English Women's Journal. And it was sort of seated one day at the organ. I was lonely and ill at ease. And it ends with, at the end of the poem, I may only in heaven hear the grand amen. And I'll try to show you the grand amen when we get to the end. But the composer of this tune and this whole organ thing, Sir Arthur Sullivan, you know, I was talking about sadness earlier. He wrote the tune when he was at his brother's deathbed. He was waiting for his brother to pass, and he took that poem and he set this tune. And it speaks to me in a different way now than I know that background for. Out of tragedy comes something that can be inspiring to someone else. So, Sir Arthur Sullivan, who we know for a lot of light opera and lots of happy things, wrote this tune to go with the Lost Chord and wrote all the organ music for it. So sit back. you heard the grand amen at the end. Well, it's your turn to have fun today, and this is also going to prepare you for my final number. So if you pull out your hymnals to page 117, and Ann and Andy are going to help me with this also, because we're going to have a variety of options for this hymn. There are six verses, and most congregations would be scared about singing six verses of a hymn. So we're going to ask everyone to sing on verse one, and for the ladies to sing on verse two, and the gentlemen sing on verse three. They must sing melody, because the harmonies will not always go with that, so you have to stay on the melody. So everyone, verse one, ladies on two, men on three. Four is going to be a trombone solo. Five is going to be a voice solo. And six will be everybody back again. And you'll just enjoy having fun with it. So if you're able, would you stand up with us and let's do this hymn.
Thank you.
you need applause also, because you never know where Jim's going to go. We changed keys three times, if you notice. That was part of the fun of it also. Before I do the final number, which is the fugue that goes with the first number, the Prelude Fugue by Bach, I want to say what a pleasure it is to have you here, and I want to thank Ron Bunker for running the online thing. Hello out there in the internet land. The worship committee has prepared some refreshments for you out in the Welcome Center. And I see all sorts of wonderful people out here in the audience. Probably the one that catches my eye the quickest is the oldest in the audience, Betty Lou Wilson over here, who turned 101 in July. And Betty Lou was the organist at this church at one point in time, I think back in the 40s. And it's great to see her continue to be active and inspire me to continue to do some things too. So we'll blame her for this recital that we did today also, because I thought, why not, yeah. So just a great pleasure to have you here. I never charge for my recitals, but often we ask you to make a donation on your way out for some cause. And right now, our church has a relationship with Habitat for Humanity, that they're building a lot of new houses and remodeling some houses in our community. There's a great housing shortage in the Zanesville area. And I do have a basket up here in front and a basket by the back door as you were heading for cookies. If you wanted to drop in a donation, that would be fine. And your people online, you could mail it to Central Trinity Church, 62 South 7th Street, Zanesville, Ohio, 43701, and mark Habitat for Humanity or Organ Recital, and that'll go to the right fund that we would send a donation from this recital. It's always nice to sort of pay it forward to something else. And so I think that might be fun also. Anyway, the tune that you just sang is the tune for the fugue. So you can hum along now, because you've got that six verses of that in your head already. And you're going to hear not quite 10 and a half minutes. It'll be a little less for the fugue, but it is a double fugue. So there'll be some times that I'll be playing two tunes at the same time. And it's in three parts also. So it's that kind of thing also. But it's a great treat having you here and all these people that have volunteered to help me. I appreciate that so much. And I so missed not doing the recital last year. This would have been the 25th year if it hadn't been for the pandemic last year. So I'm happy that you felt safe to come here today and have a cookie on the way home then. Thanks so much for coming. I forgot about the organ crawl. The pipe organ is in this L-shaped room over here, and this is one of the easiest organs to walk into in Zanesville. Some churches you have to climb ladders and pray to God that you're not going to fall off the ladder. So Schroeder Dodds wants you to meet here at the organ console, I think. And Schroeder is a volunteer that'd be happy to show you how to take a peek at the organ. And don't touch, but look. And it's fascinating, and it has a wonderful heritage. This organ originally was built by the Skinner Company to be in a mansion in Parkersburg, West Virginia. And they had a player mechanism on, like a roller, that would play the organ for breakfast, lunch, and dinner, or whatever, that kind of thing. And when this church was in need of a new pipe organ in the 40s, we were doing the World War II thing, so none of the organ companies were making organs, and this mansion had this organ in it that no one wanted. And we bought it, this church bought it, and it's now been enlarged and enhanced, but it's still the same old 1924 organ that was first in Parkersburg playing in the mansion. So Schroeder would be happy to show you the chamber also. Again, thanks for coming. Thank you.